Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy with another in the series. Well, an absolute mess, as usual. As I keep saying, it's not shaving that does this, it's modifying black wax dictation cylinders. Speaking of which, I just got a brand new, if you want to call it that, box of dictation cylinders. As you can see, they are in absolutely terrible condition. And going to be shaving this to see what's under here. So there's probably 30 of them. Now I got these for $1 a piece. As you can see, they're very small, which is great because when they're this small, it doesn't take anything to modify them into a phonograph cylinder because you have to shave them down substantially anyway. So this is what I usually look for. And as you can see, this is in just terrible condition. It's all chipped on this end. It's covered in mold and oxide. So going to do a quick test to see how deep this mold goes. And the first thing I'm going to do is put a bevel on this end to get rid of all this chipping. So to do that, I'm going to use a razor knife. Slow down the shaver a bit and just put a nice bevel on the end of this cylinder. This is where the mess comes from. That sounds better. Then roll this edge over just a bit. Do the same on this end. Alright, now we'll set the shaver. Back that off. Speed it up with the shaver. Give it one more pass. Alright, so as you see, in less than 5 minutes we've gone from a useless artifact to a usable recording blank. And this blank was $1. And it still has some mold in it. And so a couple more passes on the shaver, we can get all this out, clean up this edge, chop it off, turn it into a phonograph cylinder. And to do that, of course, we use a vernier caliper. And this is a really simple process if you have a shaver. So what I do is I use a vernier caliper and I set it to 4.3 inches. 4.3 inches is right there. And then from the end of the mandrel, I make a line, score line into the wax. Alright, so that's our cutoff point. So now using a box cutter blade, we cut the cylinder off. And you want to do this fairly slow. You don't want to cut too deep, especially on an unlined cylinder. If this is unlined and you push too hard, instead of cutting through, it will crack and usually leaves a jagged edge. So you want to cut very lightly, especially when you get right down to cutting through the cylinder to the mandrel. Throw this away, and this is solid wax, unlined. Now we clean up this edge, put a nice bevel on it, square it, roll this edge over, make it a nice new finished edge. As you see, this is where the mess comes from. So the only way to prevent this is to have a dedicated vacuum right here. Alright, and now we shave it. Get the rest of that mold out of it. Alright, let's see what it looks like. So as you see, in just a matter of a few minutes, we've gone from a useless artifact to having a viable black wax recording blank that is solid wax. This is unlined. And it has a spiral core. So, a few more passes on the shaver, clean this up. I've got a really decent recording blank for a dollar. And regardless of what anyone says, these black wax blanks will record as well as any original cylinder, and usually much better than any modern cylinder I've ever used. So, just wanted to do a video. Like I said, I've got a box full of these cylinders, and all of them are in virtually the same condition. And I've got, there's probably 35 of them right here. I'm not really sure how many there are. A box full of them. So, quite a difference in just a matter of a few minutes. And went from a useless, moldy, oxide-covered cylinder to a nice black wax cylinder for the phonograph. So this will make a great recording. So I just want to do a quick video to document it. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.